Good morning, students. I am K. Sudha, assistant professor in SLH department. Today I am going to deal one of the topic from business economics subject, that is demand analysis. Okay, so generally you have heard about demand, and you also know that demand generally, in general, the people say that it is the demand is requirement of a product. But actually in economics, as a student of economics, you have to be perfect with the meaning of demand. It is not only a requirement or desire of a person, but there are few conditions which has to get satisfied for a proper demand. So today's topic is what? Today's topic is demand analysis. Today's topic is demand analysis. So here in economics, demand analysis plays a very important role. So to study that particular demand analysis, we have to be clear with the meaning of demand. So demand demand has to satisfy three important conditions. It has to satisfy three important conditions. What are those conditions? Those conditions are, the first very important one is desire of buyer to purchase the product. Desire of the buyer to purchase the product. Second one is willingness of buyer to pay for the product. Willingness of the buyer to pay for the product. The third very important one is that ability to pay. So a proper demand should consist of these three important conditions. What are they? Desire of the buyer, willingness of the buyer to pay for the product or service, ability to pay. For example, generally, as a common person, people they think to purchase aeroplane. Okay, if a small boy, if he wants to purchase a aeroplane, a toy, we can say that is a demand. Okay, but what is the actual price of an aeroplane, real aeroplane? The cost is very high. So here, if I have the desire, okay. I am willing to buy the product also. I am ready to purchase the product also. So second condition is also satisfied. But what about the third one? Ability to pay. To pay for the aeroplane, I require crores of rupees. So we have to see the income of the person also, whether he is having the ability to pay or willingness to pay. So this is not a proper demand. So when we are discussing about the demand should fulfill these three conditions. Say that if I want to purchase a pen and the cost is 20 rupees. Okay, the cost of the pen is 20 rupees. So here I have the desire to purchase the pen. Yes, I am ready to pay for the pen also, willingness. What about the ability? Do I have 20 rupees? Yes, right now I have 20 rupees. So here the demand for pen is now a proper demand. Okay, so now I think the meaning of demand is clear. So being an economic student, always you have to say that demand, to be a proper demand, these three conditions should get satisfied. What are those three conditions? Desire, willingness and ability to pay for the product or service. So that is your demand. After that, my next one. In the demand analysis, there is another topic, that is demand determinants. Demand determinants, or it is also called as factors of demand. So in exam, don't get confused. Both are same. That is demand determinants or factors of demand. Both are same one. Okay, so here in the demand determinants, commonly there are important 8 factors. How many factors? 8 important demand determinant factors are there. First one is price of the product. Price of the product. Okay, P. Price of the product. So here, is the price of the product affecting the demand of a product? Yes. How? Same demand, I am using QD. Okay, for demand, I have used the abbreviation as QD, short form. Next one, price P. Okay, if the price of a product is increasing, what you will do with the quantity demanded? It is going to get reduced. It is going to get reduced. Say that the price of the product is decreasing. If the price is decreasing, what will happen to the quantity demanded? It will increase. It will increase. So here what is happening? If there is an increase in the price of the product, the quantity demanded is decreasing. If the price of the product is decreasing, the quantity demanded will increase. So the relationship between the price and the quantity demanded is always negative relationship. It is always negative relationship. Okay, so this relationship is called as your inverse relationship. Inverse relationship between price and the quantity demanded. Price and the quantity demanded is going to have inverse relationship between these two important things now. Okay, so after this, next one, see, or in this only, let us talk about a small example. Okay, see that the price is 10 rupees. With this price, the quantity demanded is, say that, 100 units. Okay, so here what I am saying, the price is decreased. From 10, now the price is 9 rupees. So as the price is 9 rupees, what will happen to the quantity demanded? It will increase. Say that 120 rupees. So here, next one more example. Say that the price is increasing. So as the price is increased, the quantity demanded will decrease. So whenever there is a decrease in the price, what is happening to the QD? QD is increasing. Quantity demanded is increasing. When there is an increase in the price, what is happening to QD? QD is decreasing. So because of this nature, it is called as the inverse relationship. There is an inverse relationship between the price and the quantity demanded of a product or service. Okay. So this is the first important demand determinant or factor. After this, see the next factor. Okay. So next very important factor is income of consumer. Income of consumer. Income of consumer. So here, if there is a change in the income of the consumer, if there is an increase or decrease in the income of the consumer, what will happen to the quantity demanded? It will also increase or decrease. It will also increase or decrease. Like recently, you have observed lockdown in whole India as well as in the Telangana also, we have observed the lockdown. Okay, so in this lockdown period, what happened? The income of the consumer got decreased. The income of the consumer got decreased. So as the income of the consumer is decreasing, what is happening to the quantity demanded? It also started decreasing because income is less. So what will happen to the quantity demanded? It is also going to be less. So always there is a positive relationship between, there is positive relationship between income of the consumer and demand of the product. And it is called as direct relationship. It is called as direct relationship between the income of the product and the quantity demanded. Okay, after this, now next you see third point. Price of related goods. Okay, price of related goods. related goods, short for PR. Okay, price of related goods. So in the price of related goods, we have to take two types of goods, substitutes and complementary. Substitutes and complementary goods. So substitute goods means, in place of tea, you are going to purchase coffee. In place of tea, what we will do? We will purchase coffee. So these two are substitute. Complementary good means where you are going to combine two products and you are going to get one complete service. For example, bike plus petrol, you will get the bike service. Okay, you can use bike when you are when you are combining petrol with the bike, you are going to use the bike service. So that is called as a complementary good. So now let us see the substitute. In substitute, how the price is changing and how it is affecting the substitute product. So see here, substitutes. Say that this is the quantity of X product and this is the price of X. So here price is 10 and the quantity of this is 100. Okay, the price is 10 and the quantity is 100. If the price of X, say that if it is increasing to 12, what will happen to the quantity of X? Are you going, and the price of this is same, there is no change, it is 10, now also it is 10. Okay, so the price of substitute, is it changing? It is not changing. Okay, price of substitute is not changing, but price of our product is changing. There is an increase in the price of the product. So what is happening if the price of the product is increasing? The quantity of our product will get reduced and for this it will increase. Okay, for this it is going to increase. For our product it is going to get less. Okay, so here after that next one, complementary product. In complementary goods, what is happening? If the price of bike petrol is increasing, the quantity demanded for bike will decrease. Okay, it will decrease because there is a negative relationship. In the substitute goods, it is always positive relationship, but in the complementary goods, it is always the negative relationship. Okay, so that is your price of related goods. After that, see the next one, that is fourth one, taste and preferences. Okay, taste and preference of the consumer. So based on the taste of the consumer, the quantity demanded will is going to change. It is going to increase or decrease. So what is the taste now? Like we have seen, it is the, say that trend of wearing the dresses, trend of using the mobile phone, trend of using different products. So here, whenever there is a change in this trend, what will happen to the quantity demanded? It will also change. Okay, so when the taste is changing, the quantity demanded is also going to change. Next one, Seema, fifth one is expectation about income. Expectation about income. So it is T, it is EI. Okay, expectation about income in the future. So if you are expecting a huge income in the future, what you will do today? You will purchase less quantity. If you are expecting a less income in the future, what you will do now? You will purchase more of the quantity. So that is expectation of income in the future. After that, sixth one, expectation about, expectation of price in the future. Okay, so if you are expecting an increase in the price of a product in the future, right now what you will do? You will purchase less of the product. If you are expecting increase in the price in the future you will purchase more of the product right now. If you are expecting decrease in the price of the product in future, right now what you will do? You will purchase less. So a direct relationship between expectation of price. Say that gold bar. If you are expecting the prices of gold, increase of the prices of gold in future, right now what you will do? You will purchase more. If you are expecting increase of the decrease of the price of gold in the future, right now what you will do? You will purchase less. Okay, so that is your expectation of price. That is EP. Next one, C, seventh one, advertisement. So if there is more advertisement, for example, we are seeing the advertisement of Patanjali products. Okay, so there is more advertisement of Patanjali products. So as there is more advertisement, what is happening to the quantity demanded? It is also increasing. So that is A. After that, next one is size of population. You all know that India's population, India comes at the top 2. India is having the highest population in the world, second highest population after China. So based on the population of India, what is happening? Many foreign companies, they are coming and they are selling their product in India. So because to enjoy the profit. So here size of population is also one of the demand determinants. So that is your S. Okay, so these all are your important demand determinants. So based on these demand determinants, we are going to have demand functions. So the next topic is demand function. Demand function. Okay, demand function. So in the demand function, see QD is equals to function of price of related goods, income, days, expectation of price, expectation of income, size of population and advertisement. Okay, so this is your demand function. So mathematically, if we express our demand determinants, if we express our demand determinants mathematically, that is your demand function. That is QD, quantity demanded, is equals to function of price of the related goods, income, taste, expectation of price, expectation of income, size of population and advertisement. Okay, thank you students.